Yeah, so, since I'm recording, yeah, 1.4 to 1, or so 1.1 to 1.5 quiz is coming up probably the first part of next week. And this book has great review problems. If you look at the end of the chapter sometime, there's like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 pages of just review problems. And they're cut up, and they're organized by section. So those are very good review problems for the quiz. Okay? So that's just something to think about. Anything from last night you want to look at? Yeah. 79. You bet. Okay. Oh, this x squared minus x minus 1. Okay? Good. I was hoping somebody would ask that. 1... 2, 3, so, and what does the difference quotient mean in relationship to the graph? What does it mean? Slope. It's the slope. In this case, it's the slope at 2 plus a little bit. Okay? I love your shirt. Okay? So now let's work on this. F of 2 plus h. So we're going to take 2 plus h, and we're going to plug it in for x. Okay. What is the difference quotient? F of 2. So we got minus, and F of 2, let me scroll out just a little bit. That would be 2 squared minus 2 plus 1 all over h. So the first challenge is just getting it started. Now let's go ahead and multiply this out. 2 plus h times 2 plus h. Now we multiply that out. 4 plus 4h plus h squared minus, if there's any point in time, Ian, that you're not quite sure where I came up with something, stop me. Okay? We still have the minus. And I just get in the habit of, I don't really calculate this, I just distribute the negative. Why? Because each one of them will cancel individually every single time. Every single time. Okay? So you'll notice that my 4 will cancel. My 2 will cancel. And my 1s will cancel. So I'm just left with 4h plus h squared minus h over h, and I probably should have combined those like terms like a knucklehead. I forgot. And then I divide everything by h on the top. Is that correct? Yes. There we go. Find your mistake? Good. Okay. Remember, this is the first part of calculus, technically, finding difference quotients, and then we would move on to limits, and then evaluate that as h approached 0. So basically, in this case, as h got small, my slope there would be 3. We just found the slope of a curve when x is 2. Okay? Yeah? Yes. Yep. Because that's the most common mistake, is if you don't put the parentheses around it, you'll be subtracting the first term only instead of the whole thing. Since you're subtracting this whole function, I'm going to put parentheses around it to make sure that I subtract that whole function, not just the first term of that function. Okay? Anything else? Okay, so we'll just consider that, and for those that aren't here, we have 6 gone out of 11, so we are going to just take some time to work on something a little bit different for which you are not going to be responsible for. For which you are not going to be responsible. I put another 4 in there. Okay, so we'll see you on Thursday.